Hello and welcome to our Test and Measurement Basic Show, where we will show you tips and tricks to make the most out of your measurement. I'm Tipin, and today we're going to talk about 5 ways in which your DAQ can help you do more. So what's a DAQ? Let's say if you have a physical property you like to measure. In this case, we are using temperature. A transducer from the DAQ will transform this into an electrical signal. It can be voltage or current or even resistance. So it will be sent over to the signal conditioning circuit, where the signal will be adjusted and have a noise reduced so that it's easier to work with. And once that's done, the signal will be sent over to your ADC, or we call it analog to digital converter. So the analog to digital converter will convert this into your digital signal, 0010. And this digital signal will then be sent over to your computer for storing, or it can be used for your data analysis so that you get more insight into your data. So what does this mean to you? So the first thing is the DAQ offers flexibility. Because of the built-in signal conditioning over here, you can use whatever sensor that you like for your job. You don't have to worry about the complexity of the circuit and the setup. Right, number two is easy documentation. Because your data is sent over to your PC for storing, you have control over how it's organized and stored, so that you can meet with your organization's quality standards like ISO and regulatory requirements. Number three, because the data is sent over to your PC, you can use software like MATLAB or Minitab and even BenchView to help you get more insights into the data that you're collecting. Number four, DAQ saves you money. Because you just need a single DAQ to have multiple measurements. Example, imagine replacing 120 thermocouple data loggers with a single DAQ. Last but not least, the DAQ comes with a variety of options and accessories. There are thermistors and thermocouple kits, there are switch modules that you can choose from, and even Z540 calibration standards. For more information, you can visit keysight.com. I hope you enjoy our episode today. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. I hope to see you soon, and happy measuring.